movies are getting longer. We looked back at runtimes over the last 100 years. We see this sharp increase in the decades leading up to modern filmmaking, and we see stagnation and actually a decrease in the 90s and 2010s before a sharp increase in the last couple of years, with the longest runtimes in 2023 at 96 minutes on average. But the reasons for this increase have to do with the shifting economic landscape of the filmmaking industry in the last really 10 years. 20 or 30 years ago, a 3+ hour movie was super rare because there's this inherent tension between the studios and the theaters. It's harder to fill theaters for a 3-hour movie. And even if you do fill the theater, you can only have half the showtimes as like a 90-minute movie. While making runtimes longer for studios is trivial, just cut less of the footage, a lot ends up on the cutting room floor anyway. And while this tension between the studios and the theaters still exists, the circumstances are quite different. Streaming, for its part, has a role to play. Streaming services actually started becoming studios, really with Beasts of No Nation in 2015, which was released directly to Netflix. And this trend of streaming services making movies has continued, looking to disrupt the traditional moviegoer experience. At around the same time that Beasts of No Nation came out, ticket prices were increasing at about 3% every year. But this didn't stop people from going to theaters altogether. That would require some large-scale behavioral change, which happened right about here in 2020. And studios and theaters haven't quite recovered from that. They especially haven't recovered to the pre-pandemic heyday in the 2010s. And this kind of aligns the incentives of the studios and the theaters to make movies more like experiences, something you can't quite get or wouldn't watch continuously at home, and something that justifies the price. Now you know. Like and follow for more.